Captain, incoming message.
Hold on.
There. Now we can see you. All right. So, yeah, so this was a really wild week, wasn't it, between Mando and Picard?
Yeah, extremely. First of all, I just want to say, called that shit on Picard. From day one, called that shit. Called it. Motherfucking called it.
Oh, I know. Like, and so we find out that that hand monster, as I kept calling it, was actually the Borg Queen. So that was something that that Terry Metalis came out and it finally acknowledged that the being that
I missed that. To.
Yeah, it was somewhere. I was reading it today, actually, where somebody had, where they'd come out and said that.
Sorry.
Yeah, so let's talk Picard first, I guess. Oh, I know, they're getting me too. But yeah, let's talk about Picard, because that's what I want to talk about the most. So the Enterprise-D, we have the Enterprise-D is back in, well, it's flying again.
With the same crew.
Oh, I know. And yeah, so have you watched the Ready Room yet, or at least seen the trailer?
I still have not watched the Ready Room or the trailer yet. I was finishing Your Mom's Bicycle.
Okay, yeah. We're going to watch the trailer then here. In a, you know what?
What if I don't want to watch the trailer? What if I want it to be kind of suspenseful? what if I want to go into the next episode, you know? No forgivings, no, you know.
But this is what we do for a living, so we watch the trailer. Let's watch the trailer.
Well, I mean,
that's
a fair point. I guess I can't argue with you there.
Yeah, we'll watch the trailer here in a minute. So
I actually don't have any. Go ahead.
Yeah. So a few good. So some points from this particular episode, though, we find out Jack is Vox of Borg. Like his father, who was Locutus, so the Queen had said that Locutus was, I can't remember what the word, but basically Vox is the voice of the Borg, where Locutus was the one that spoke it.
Yeah.
And yeah, so.
So who do you think would win in a fight, Locutus or Jet Crusher Picard as a Borg?
I think it'd be Jack. He's got a few tricks up his sleeve that Locutus didn't. But yeah, so all sorts of really interesting things came out of this. So we have there's so many things that came back from into this episode that they keep bringing back. So like the actual actress that played the Borg Queen, Alice Creege, she's the one that played the Queen in First Contact.
Oh no shit!
Like the first time, the first time we ever saw a Borg Queen was played by Alice Creege, and she comes back in this one. So that's whose voice it is.
Is it
so
the same Borg Queen?
Yes, canonically it is the same Borg Queen, even though the one that we had at the end of Voyager wasn't played by the same actress. As far as the storyline is concerned, those are the same queens.
It's the same queen.
Yeah, so we know that she got screwed up really bad on the Enterprise-E. So I don't know how that queen actually came back. But again, we saw her again in Voyager and what Janeway did in Endgame, where future Janeway rather unleashed that virus and really screwed the Borg up.
Yeah.
So that's why the Borg have been really weak ever since the end of Voyager.
I mean, I suppose technically being Borg, she can take a, you know, new form whenever she needs.
Yeah. And I think in the last episode, last season of Picard, we kind of find out that all the Borg queens are interconnected through different things. Like the body may have physically died, but does the consciousness go? And I think the Borg Queen is immortal. Even if you kill the body, I think the essence of
what if you kill the entire queen, cube?
I don't know. All I know is we have Borg Queen coming.
Have we
back.
Ever killed a cube?
Oh yeah, lots of them.
But, I mean, yeah, sorry, not cube, but like, I guess, how would you break that down? Would it be one Borg Queen would be one?
That's a good question. But either way, so like the reveal for the Enterprise D, though. So we go back to like the first episode of this episode of Picard, and Picard wants to give LaForge his painting of the Enterprise D. Little did Picard know that LaForge was planning on giving Picard the actual Enterprise D.
Yeah.
And we got.
Did my video cut out?
Video cut out. But, yeah, so that was really fascinating that happened the way it did. And, but yeah, so we take a look at Jack. So that was crazy. Finding out that the whole thing that they wanted out of dead Picard's body was the this particular genetic sequence, and they were using that to infect everybody in Starfleet 25 years of age or under with this DNA, so that way all they had to do was pass through a transporter and they would get infected. And that's why the changelings weren't using the transporters. They were using the they were using the shuttles and stuff, and they did not want to use transporters because they didn't want the Borg stuff in them, because they knew it'd screw them up. And so anybody that's older, like Riker, and you know, just anybody that's older than 25,
over the age
it's like their frontal lobe is fully developed, so that DNA sequence wasn't going to do anything. And of course Jack completely owns this. Like he keeps trying to tell his dad, well, I'm me and I'm not worried about what the Queen's gonna do to me.
Yeah.
And I thought that's like, okay, that's really crazy, because like you should be afraid of the Borg, but yet he is a Borg. He understands and finally realizes that he himself is a Borg, whether he likes it or not, whether he knew it all along. He always knew he was different, and now it's finally coming out that he's a Borg. And Picard never having Iromatic syndrome, that was
weird. Go ahead.
Yeah, because this was something that we had believed that he had ever since the end of the very last episode of Next Generation, All Good Things, where they had future Picard, future everybody, and Picard was like a crazy old man that had Iromatic syndrome. And so we don't actually find out that he had, you know, any sort of problems like this until after he comes back from the Borg, after he's been assimilated and then unassimilated, and you know, and they thought that they got all of the stuff out. But the thing that the Enterprise D computers at the time, that the scanners and all the medical science they had then couldn't pick up, was this change in his DNA.
On a very, very like molecular, super sneaky squirrel fucking Borg sort of way.
So we didn't even, you know, now we're You know, now the way they set the table now is everybody in Starfleet that's 25 years of age or younger
Is Borg.
is Borg, and then they so we got Jack Crusher that's over with the Borg Queen, which we're gonna watch this trailer and we're gonna know exactly where they're hiding. But either way,
So
she's with
hold
the
on,
Borg
before
Queen.
we watch the trailer, you still holding out hope for Jack and
Oh yeah,
his battle for the with the Borg Queen? You think he's gonna pull it?
I really think that Jack's gonna screw the Queen over because he so Jack is
I think his. Go ahead.
everything about Jack is the direct opposite of what the Borg are. The Borg have no individuality. The Borg, I mean, they're just, it's all about order, and
I
Jack
think
is
his,
about none of that.
and I think his hatred is what's gonna like
Yeah, he's going
his
to
hate
bring.
for being told what to do.
Yeah, Jack is such a jerk that he's going to bring chaos to order, essentially, in the way the Borg would re respond to that and call that. And yeah, that's which I think is hilarious. But yeah, so we have, the Enterprise D, they're heading to Earth. All of the ships that are active in Starfleet are at Earth. They're getting ready to start sh firing at the Earth space dock, and then after that, it's just a matter of time
You
before
know
the
what I just
planetary.
realized? Jack and the Borg Queen would be like if Deadpool and the Borg Queen.
Right, and they're gonna
It,
go,
go ahead.
and so like we got planetary shields that are gonna go down, if they don't, no time at all against that fleet. And it's like, yeah, so we
I
got
mean,
all sorts.
there's no defense left.
And then it's like we can't sit there and let's take a look at the other cameo that we had, Admiral Shelby,
Yeah.
which they finally gave her a first name. She didn't have a first name. Nobody ever knew what her
She
first
didn't,
name
did
was.
she?
No. So what they ended up doing was they just gave her the actor's first name. Admiral Elizabeth Shelby. But
Huh.
anyway, so let me go play this trailer real quick and we'll talk about that.
The fleet has initiated an attack formation against Earth.
Orbital weapon platforms have been destroyed, but space dock's defenses appear to be repelling the assault.
For now. Planetary shields won't hold against that fleet. Where the hell is the cavalry?
Emergency hails from both Federation and civilian ships have now gone silent. Apparently, we are the cavalry.
The fleet is being controlled by the collective, a hive mind with a single voice. The Borg are here. Mr. Data.
Scanning, Captain.
If space dock falls, there'll be nothing standing between an assimilated fleet and Earth.
If Earth falls, everything falls. Every planet, every system.
Long-range sensors are picking up a Borg vessel. Jupiter, sir.
Lay in a course. Maximum warp.
Aye, Captain.
Engage.
All right, so the Borg cube is hiding by Jupiter.
Or in Jupiter.
Or in Jupiter. Yeah, that's true. That would make some sense.
It is a gas
Because where
giant.
they yeah because, yeah, so the whole gas giant thing, like when we saw pictures of like the scenery from this episode of where the Borg cube was behind that red door,
Yeah.
that was the right color of gases to be Jupiter.
Oh, yeah.
I thought it was a nebula, and it might still be, but it makes more sense now that it's Jupiter.
Jupiter's rings, or one of its moons.
Yeah, but either way, so we have, they're coming up on Jupiter, and all of the civilian defense vessels and everything is silent. And like Picard said, we are the cavalry.
I mean, you would think that other races, like the Vulcan, the
They're all of them are part of the Federation, and all of them, all of their capable people are in Starfleet at Earth right now. That's the problem. And honestly, when you see that many Starfleet ships in one place, you know, they're good. By the time somebody like the Klingons or the Romulans, even, or just anybody, would be able to get a fleet or two across the galaxy in time, Earth's gonna fall. So, I mean, yeah, the best bet right now is a 40-year-old starship with 80-year-old crew members.
True, but very, 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 we'll say, crafty 80-year-old.
Right.
Crew members. And a pissed off son of daddy issues.